is a world full of darkness, but we all see light. And there's a world full of pain, but we all survive. In our own different ways, our own different styles, only way we know. We're just living off love and loving by faith. Please give us hope to see what we want to see and be who we want to be. It doesn't hurt to go where you've never been before. Did not our hearts burn in our souls? Did not our hearts burn in our souls? All my life, I always saw the world with a closed mind, until I went and saw the truth that lies behind. It's a great big world with a great big price that we all must pay. But together we might, together we can make a change and see what we wanna see and be who we want to be. It doesn't hurt to go where you've never been before. Did not our hearts burn in our souls? Did not our hearts burn in our souls?
Let you go. child bitter with rage, blind and broken under this weight. Seek me first and you will find righteousness for your heart, peace for your mind. I came to find you in me, you will be found. No matter what, no matter what may come, no matter what may come, I will not let you go. This love is for you, no matter what you do, it does not depend on who you are or where you have been, on what you said or what have seen. No matter what, no matter what may come, no matter what may come, I will not let you go. No matter what, no matter what may
disputation was read, giving birth to a conversation. But the word quickly spread, and all the people said that this is gonna be a reformation, where the gospel and the law are properly distinct, where sinner and the saint are inextricably linked, where by faith the just are alive, where God is in communion with all the baptized. Martin Luther. Now Luther was a man doing everything one can to keep the law of God and all that it required. He traveled far from home, made a pilgrimage to Rome, but what he saw was not the life to which his soul aspired. When Tetzel came along with a coffer and a song, Luther's flock in Wittenberg was confused, and Luther was dismayed that money had been paid for what was free, and that the gospel was abused. Martin Luther. Well, the Pope issued a statement demanding Luther's abatement, but Luther could not in confidence recant. And at the hands of the Pope's legations, he endured interrogations, and at arms Luther responded, "Here I stand." Well, the Emperor called for Luther's arrest, but along the road at Prince Frederick's behest, soldiers kidnapped Luther, the prince's vassal, and protected as a knight, he invested time to write a common language text at Wartburg Castle. Now common people on their own could see the light that the scriptures shone on the creeds, confessions, prayers, and no less. They could evaluate church teaching, singing, and the preaching throughout Europe, thanks to Gutenberg's press. Martin Luther. The pulpit and the pen, the culture and the can, the gospel's joy proclaimed and sinners sought. Confess your sin, and when you do, boldly trust in Christ, it's true. Eine feste Burg ist unser Gott. And Martin Luther in 1517 held a hammer before popes and kings and queens. He hit the nail on the head when the disputation was read, giving birth to a conversation. But the word quickly spread, and soon the people said, this is gonna be a reformation, where the gospel and the law are properly distinct, where sinner and the saint are inextricably linked, where by faith the just are alive, and where God is in communion with all the baptized. Martin Luther in 1517 held a hammer.